And it's not about environmental students, it's about all students. It's not about environmental companies, it's about all companies. It's not about progressive governments, it's about all governments. It's not about education, it's about all of humanity. We are all activists, we are all change makers, we are all inspirations on this planet. There are no passengers, we are all crew, as been famously said before in the past. So yes, let us look to the past. There is a lot to learn from the past, but it is now the present that matters. Let us not wait for tomorrow. Let us begin today by changing our minds and becoming fully empowered that we can reverse this global warming, this climate change, this loss of resources. I don't need to list the symptoms of what's happening in the world today. They are endless symptoms. But what you must remember, they are symptoms. They are not the root cause of what's happening to our environment. The root cause lies within our minds. Once we change that, we can exponentially, and we are exponentially, changing the idea that there is no hope for us, that environmental Armageddon is coming, that global warming is here forever. No, we created global warming, but we can solve global warming. And the best way to do it, in my opinion, in my experience, the most effective way, the quickest way, without having to wait for governments, without having to wait for policy change, without having to wait to corporations, without having to wait for anyone, we can start today by becoming environmental, spiritual, ecological, humanitarian change makers. Guess how? What is the single thing we can change today? April 25th, 2018, and have the biggest impact on global warming, climate change, etc. There's one thing we can change right away, and we don't need money in the bank to do it. We don't need to wait for anyone. And that is to simply change our diets. By changing our diets, we change the world. And I'm not advocating anyone to become vegan or vegetarian. I'm just simply saying reduce your consumption of meat, fish, and dairy today, because their eco footprint is enormous beyond our comprehension. Let us empower ourselves and empower our community and our professors and our teachers and our university and our parents and our brothers and sisters and our siblings by leading through example, so we change our diet and not the climate. We can all do this, and we are in the millions, in the hundreds of millions. This is how we can change. And change we are. And this is unstoppable. It is spreading from mind to mind, from heart to heart, across the entire planet. So let us rejoice, let us celebrate, not just this wonderful inauguration of Gaia, Mother Earth, but let us celebrate the fact that we are changing the world. One mind at a time, one heart at a time.